Good evening, Lake Gibson High School seniors. Welcome to our virtual Legacy Leaders and Senior Award Ceremony. We know that your school year did not end the way that you expected, but we are so proud of your accomplishments, and tonight we celebrate them all. We are so excited to celebrate with our seniors tonight, so please join us in congratulating them at this time. Just give a virtual clap to our seniors. And now, our wonderful administrative team.
Summer Fisher, Assistant Principal.
Elizabeth DeShazer, Assistant Principal.
Debbie Donahue, Assistant Principal.
Matt Diaz, Assistant Principal.
And now, our Student Success Coach, Antoinette Bazunu, will begin the Legacy Leaders Ceremony.
Greetings. My name is Antoinette Bazunu, and I am the Student Success Coach and College and Career Coordinator here at Lake Gibson High School. Seniors, it was a pleasure and honor working with all of you this year. I appreciate your hard work with completing college applications, navigating through the FAFSA, writing admission essays, requesting letters of recommendation, applying to scholarships, meeting with military recruiters, and so much more. Right now, we will be doing a Legacy Leaders recognition segment. Legacy Leaders is Lake Gibson's annual event where we celebrate our seniors who will be going to college, vocational school, enlisting into the military, or have gained full-time employment in the workforce. I wish you all the very best and much success in your future endeavors. Remember to always be kind to others, stay humble, maintain positive thoughts, never give up on yourself, and never stop reaching higher. Now, I present to you our Class of 2020 Legacy Leaders.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame. You can run the mile, you can walk straight through with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Yeah, banging on his heart.
Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I hope you dance. I hope you never fear those mountains in the distance. Never settle for the path of least resistance. Living might mean taking chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance. Keep score.
gonna make.
Hi, this is Mrs. Anspaugh. I am one of the senior class sponsors, and I'm also the Lake Gibson High School Counselor Department Chair. Welcome. The class of 2020 valedictorian is not only an outstanding scholar, he has been outstanding in the student life at Lake Gibson as well. Not only has he participated in various athletic activities, he has volunteered, worked part-time, participated in orchestra, and was a reporter and editor for the school newspaper. This incredible young man plans to attend the University of Florida in the fall, where he will pursue a career as a clinical and research psychiatrist. Successfully completing 11 honors, 9 AP, and 14 dual enrollment courses with a graduation GPA of 4.697, it is my pleasure to introduce the valedictorian, Kenneth Caraballo Guerin. It is my great pleasure that I'm here to introduce the class of 2020 salutatorian. This amazing young lady maintained one of the top academic ranks and GPA throughout her high school career. Carrying a graduation GPA of 4.606, her academic curriculum has included 12 advanced placement, 13 honors level, and 8 dual enrollment college courses. She also has completed the fourth and final course in the Biotechnology Academy. From the time she was in middle school, she began to pursue projects in the veterinary medicine field. She even worked with scientists from UF and IFAS, applying her biotechnology skills. This fall, she will begin her college career at the University of Florida, pursuing a major in the veterinary medicine field. I present to you Lake Gibson High School Class of 2020 salutatorian, Sophia Castrillon. It is my pleasure to introduce to you the Class of 2020 Senior Class Officers. These seniors have had the responsibility of making decisions that impacted the senior class and worked closely with the senior sponsors and administration. It is also their future responsibility to plan your class reunions and help the Class of 2020 stay in touch. Each senior officer has prepared a short speech for you. So here they are, your senior class officers, President Cherise Villiers, Vice President Alana Bush, Secretary Oscar Santiago Perez, and Treasurer Erica Scott.
I'd like to start by saying how much of a pleasure it has been to be your senior class treasurer and to represent Lake Gibson High School. While we didn't get to do everything we planned this year, I want to take a few minutes to reflect on what life was like before any of this started, before high school was a thought in our mind, and before we realized what life really was. Let's take it all the way back to elementary school, back to when we rocked silly bands and somehow managed to get them banned from the classroom, or when we walked into the Scholastic Book Fair feeling like millionaires, or when we all started this face. Yeah, can't wait to tell my future kids I did that in front of my senior class. And how could we forget about field days? Those are like the Olympics. Double Dutch, capture the flag, water races. We really did deserve gold medals. At the time, elementary school was nothing but one giant playground. Sure, we learned how to write in cursive and do our times tables. Well, some of us. Sorry, Mr. Baker. But one thing we took for granted was our mindset. All we thought about was happiness and fun. We didn't stress ourselves out if we couldn't write our names in kindergarten because we knew we'd get it eventually. We didn't beg for people's approval because we knew we were important. Our safety patrol belts proved that. We were just kids with hearts of gold and dreams bigger than the sky. Think about all the dreams we had. We wanted to grow up and be professional athletes and superstars. But as we got older, we told ourselves that wasn't possible, wasn't realistic. You know, we never had to give up on those dreams. We never had to stop believing in ourselves. I guess what I'm trying to say is, don't be afraid to go back to that childhood mindset, to when we didn't know the word mistake, or to when we couldn't even spell it. Don't be afraid to go after things you once gave up on. Chances are, if you can't stop thinking about it, it's probably worth keeping. The mind is a powerful thing, and it starts to believe what you tell it. So start by going back to the basics. back to when we all actually wanted PE class, and to when toilet paper wasn't a luxury item. Go back to when your imagination wasn't something you just gave away. Now be prepared to be taken back to middle school with our secretary, Oscar.
Greetings, my fellow seniors. I'm joining you during this unprecedented time to celebrate our accomplishments. Firstly, I want to congratulate each of you for successfully navigating through online learning. Since we just heard about elementary school, let's talk a little about middle school. Dreaded by some, loved by others. We started middle school in 2013, and during this time, we began to learn a lot about ourselves and who we'd become. We started to watch movies like Frozen, The Hunger Games, or the first of the newer Star Wars trilogy. We started to listen and like the music of One Direction, Katy Perry, or Lorde, and even if you didn't listen to these artists, you were finding the genre that fit your personality. We were beginning to identify with the culture of the time. You probably were beginning to sleep later from the bedtime set during elementary days, and your parents began to assign you chores, marking a point in which you realized that you were growing up. Middle school was also a time when you began to create the friendships that have lasted to this day. You were going out to friends' houses for sleepovers more frequently than in elementary, and that would lead, eventually, to the inseparable bond that you have with your best friend. Middle school was a time of physical and mental growth, and I encourage every single one of you to continue growing. Life's experiences will bring you many opportunities to grow. I personally have grown from my experiences in Puerto Rico, and right now is a perfect time for self-reflection and to think how you can grow into a better person for tomorrow. We will all learn from this experience, but what lessons we take from this are up to you. Only you can do that. All I hope is that it's for the better. Thank you, and now let's hear from about the last 4 years of our lives from our Vice President, Alana.
Hello, everyone. I first like to give honor to Christ, who is our Lord and Savior of my life. Without him, we wouldn't be here today. So I'd like to thank him first. I thank all of our faculty, teachers, staff, administrators, family, and friends for joining us today. This wasn't the speech I had at first, but I only have a few minutes, so bear with me. Seemed like yesterday we were just freshmen walking the halls, knowing that we would take over and let everyone know class of 2020 was going to be the best to ever do it. A few memories with teachers we can't forget. Anyone that had Ms. Fowler knew she was a good teacher, but was quick to say detention or insubordination. Never walk past Ms. Dinwiddie without giving her the knuckle. Never say you don't know anything in her class, because she'll always come back to you and ask for your answer. Ms. Johnson, who isn't with us today, everyone knew in video production, 1-2-3 action, was not going to stop the class from talking. Oh, how we'll miss Ms. Sherman, giving us bell work every day, with a lesson, doing experiments, and a test the week after. Buenos dias, señorita McSwain. If you didn't know Spanish, I promise you knew in her class, and would randomly sing the Spanish songs in the hallway and do the dances. I recommend you guys to listen to La Cintura. We enjoy hearing Ms. Miller always saying Happy National Cheeseburger Day or Happy National Ice Cream Day. We'll miss Ms. Tulo's jokes of the day and her teaching, then assigning 25 problems at the end of the lesson and saying, you have time to do it after class, when it was 5 minutes left. We love Ms. Rodino's sarcasm. Sometimes we would be afraid to ask her something because we wouldn't know if it was serious or sarcasm. The class could be hard, not going to lie, but at the end of the day, she helped us realize what it's going to be like in the real life, or what to expect when it's typing essays for college. Anyone ever gets Wendy's from Ms. Myers, she says she likes dream bacon cheeseburger, spicy chicken nuggets with barbecue sauce. Thank you to everyone in guidance, Anspa, Jones, Bazunu, Greer, Minshew, and Rainey, for helping us whether it was for class changes or trying to get documents to send off to our colleges. Thank you to Ms. Johnson for having Gibson glitter. It helped some of us showcase our talents to the school that people didn't know we could do. Anyone that had class with me knew I put Mr. Kretzer on Young Boy. As he would say, never broke again, young boy. We loved his stories, and some of the stories we could repeat after him because he retells them. Mr. Copper, not only was he a football and track coach, he was a teacher and would give us advice and teach us life lessons and encourage his students to do better and find purpose in life. Lastly, Ms. Sissel. Hey kiddos, she helped us in a lot of ways. She always believed in every single one of her students and would always push and motivate us to do better and strive for success. We all had our up and downs, shed a few tears. She never gave up on us, and I appreciate her for that. Thank you, sis. Who would have known March 13th would have been our last day walking the halls and seeing some of our friends? It's been 4 years, and now it's finally paid off, and we're wearing our square-shaped hats. Lake Gibson High School is a place where teachers encouraged us to break a status quo, define ourselves as we choose. It's a place where one person, if it's the right person, changes us all. Lake Gibson is having friends and memories that we'll keep for the rest of our lives. And I guess this means, from quote, High School Musical, we're all in this together. Because once a brave, always a brave. Thank you. Now we are going to look at the future with our class president, Cherise.
Class of 2020, man, what a year. We were named the class of clear vision, but we definitely did not see any of this coming. Reflecting over the years, I realized that we have overcame so much since we began high school. From tropical storms, solar eclipse, and the craziest of them all, COVID-19. I can honestly say we are true survivors. Through all situations life has hit us with, we managed to find a way to remain positive and see the light at the end of every tunnel. It's the year of 2024. Most of us are fresh out of college, trade school, or vocational school, and about to take on every aspect of the real world that we are taught about. We're nervous because now we're really on our own. We constantly check our Facebook feed to see if our old classmates are coping with this new spin on life. Some of us are flourishing and got adulting on lock, and some of us, not so much. But it's okay, because this is just the beginning. There will be more obstacles, and just like we did in the past, we will overcome them one step at a time. This is adulthood in full effect. We now understand the saying, there's food at the house. I'm extremely blessed to have been president of a class of such strength and resilience, and I look forward to seeing what amazing things each and every one of you do in the future. We are the next innovators and creators. I won't be long, so I'll end my speech with this. Class of 2020, we may have lost a lot of things this year, but we made something so much bigger, history. Thank you so much. I love you all. Go Braves.
We'll be right back. This male athlete has played 2 years of varsity football and 2 years of varsity baseball. Not only did he perform well on the field, he excelled academically as well. He has been a studious role model to his peers and is graduating with highest honors. Congratulations to Julian Cervantes, the Male Scholar Athlete of the Year. This female athlete led well in her leadership role on the varsity cheerleading team and track and field. Graduating with highest honors, this athlete has volunteered over 1,000 hours to her community, is a team player, and consistently excels on and off the field. Congratulations to Charisse Villiers, the Female Scholar Athlete of the Year. The Male Athlete of the Year is a three-sport athlete. He was on the varsity baseball team for 3 years and was batting .300 with one home run and four RBIs. He was on the varsity soccer team for 4 years and was on the varsity football team for 1 year. Congratulations to Tanner Oakley, Male Athlete of the Year. The Female Athlete of the Year played 3 years on the volleyball team with 110 kills and 64 digs. She was also on the varsity softball team for 4 years, batting .367 with 7 RBIs and a .900 fielding percentage. Congratulations to Jade Kennedy, Female Athlete of the Year.
It is an honor to be able to recognize the seniors who have earned 260 or more community service hours. These seniors have volunteered with the Youth Impact Program, Police Athletic League, Boys and Girls Club. They have assisted teachers and gone to nursing homes, and they even helped neighbors with storm cleanup. Although students who volunteer are not doing so for the acknowledgement, it is my pleasure to be able to recognize the following students for going well above and beyond. With 260 community service hours, Abriana McMillan. Haley Leach with 280, Amira Yacoub, 285, Katiana Aviles Laquente, 300, Tatiana Henderson, also 300, Jesse Gare, 325, Sean Paraprasad, 330, Oscar Santiago Perez, 330, Ariana Farula, 350. Shyla Sortman, 385 hours. Jayla Worlds, 419. Jessica Zoe, 420. Matisha Benson, 440. Jared Thompson, 460. Sierra Helms, 464. Delicia Oglesby, 495. Hitting the 500 range, Destiny Goulet with 505. Maria Torres Morales, 514. Christian Barbosa, 570. In the 600 range, Taraya Demings, 655. Ronnie Gaskin with 710. Mercy Williams, 975. And receiving an exceeding expectations medallion with 1,500 volunteer hours, Charisse Villiers. Congratulations and thank you for all your hard work, seniors.
Good evening, I'm Laura Tulowicki, the National Honor Society Advisor. I would like to congratulate our 27 National Honor Society graduates. Not only did they complete hundreds of hours of community service this year, but they are all graduating with a GPA of 3.5 or higher and have adhered to the principles of character, service, leadership, and scholarship. First, I would like to recognize our senior NHS officers. Our senior representative, Oscar Santiago Perez, our historian, Katiana Aviles, our treasurer, Estefania San Javier Arriaga, our secretary, Bailey Williams, and our president, Abriana McMillan. And the following are our other graduating seniors: Christian Barbosa, Mitesha Benson, Avery Brown, Sophia Castrillon, Karen Diaz, Emily Duval, Sydney Hamilton, Morgan Harris, Narida Hernandez, Liberty Jackson, Dominique Naveau, Delicia Oglesby, Ariana Oldham, Emily Pierce, Amarian Poe, Laura Porter, Tania Thomas, Jared Thompson, Kalia Vang, Cherise Villiers, Mercy Williams, and Marlena Yarbrough. Congratulations to all of you and good luck.
Hello, I'm Eric Haynes. I'm a math teacher and senior sponsor at Lake Gibson High School. Tonight I'll be presenting the JRTC military recognition. The JRTC department would like to recognize the following students as they plan to enlist in the following military branches: O'Brien Barnes, Marines; Michael Lawrence, Marines; Wilson Mendez Pena, Marines; Harris Pierre, United States Army Reserve; Michael Quiles Diaz, Army National Guard; Donovan Rivera, Army National Guard; Braden Rochette, Navy; Estefania San Javier, United States Army Reserve; Ariana Ferula, Army in the near future; and Kiana Baez, Army National Guard. Congratulations and thank you for your desire to serve our country.
Hi, I'm Ms. Rodino. I teach dual enrollment and senior English for honors, and I am a proud senior sponsor of the class of 2020. Today, I will be presenting a few of our department awards, and we'll be starting with the Department of Art. Mrs. Phelps, the art teacher, has taught the student for several years. During that time, the student has shown incredible growth, not only in their art, but also in their responsibility toward their studies. There are others that have great talent in art, but this student has a big heart and humble personality to go with it. They are dedicated to their studies and have worked very hard to overcome obstacles. They need to know their efforts have been seen, are greatly appreciated, and deserve to be rewarded. Congratulations to Evelyn Garrett, recipient of the Department of Arts Outstanding Senior Award. Our next department is Digital Media. The student has shown a true passion for TV production during their 4 years at Lake Gibson. They have always been the first to offer help for recording videos on and off campus for clubs and sporting events. They wrote, directed, and filmed our documentary for the 2020 ITV Awards, which was no easy task. They did a wonderful job, and they even beat the deadline by a few weeks. This student has shown so much growth in their confidence and professionalism since her freshman year in the program. Congratulations to Ronnie Gaskin, recipient of the Digital Media Department's Outstanding Senior Award. Next is Department of Theater. The student has taken all theater arts coursework offered at Lake Gibson and has been involved in 8 main stage productions as an actor, technician, and designer. The student has earned superior ratings, competing at All County Theater Festival, and has been an active member of the International Thespian Society ever since freshman year. Serving as 2-time host of LG's Theater Gibby Awards, the student has commanded the respect of their fellow performers and technicians during their stay here. You simply won't find another person as kind, generous, and authentic as this student. The Department of Theater is proud to recognize Michael Martinez as its most outstanding senior. Next, we have the Education Academy. The student has excelled in both tracks, principles of teaching and early childhood education. They strive to do their best and is always one of the most creative students in the academy. The student is a natural-born teacher, and the Little Braves preschoolers gravitate to their enthusiastic demeanor. The student takes their role as an officer very seriously, and they serve as a role model to many others. Mrs. Woodard and Ms. McCullen would like to thank this student for their leadership as president of the Education Academy. Congratulations to Shiloh Sortman, recipient of the Education Academy's Outstanding Senior Award. Our next department award is for the Academy of Health. The Academy of Health wants to recognize this student for being a driven person with a passion for medicine and healthcare research. The student has maintained an A average over all 4 years in the academy. They have completed all capstone requirements and have earned industry certifications. Additionally, they have gone above and beyond through future health professionals, competitions, and service projects. Congratulations to Cameron Van Horn, recipient of the Health Academy's Outstanding Senior Award. And last, I will be presenting the English Department Award. This student began the school year wondering if it would be possible to make it through the semester, let alone the year, of my dual enrollment English composition course. While juggling health academy requirements, prepping for a spring sport, and trying to maintain excellent grades in multiple AP and dual enrollment classes, this student grew academically and emotionally through the year. After many tears and many faux claims of dropping out that never came to fruition, I'm excited to celebrate this young lady and her future accomplishments at Palm Beach Atlantic University. Congratulations to Astrid Diaz Martinez, recipient of the English Department's Outstanding Senior Award. Thank you.
Now I'll present the JROTC Department Award. This student is a gifted leader who is handpicked by the battalion operations officer due to the ability to plan, communicate, and see things through to completion. This cadet does not disappoint. This cadet's leadership has our battalion headed in a positive direction. The coordination from their efforts has increased student involvement in various extracurricular activities. Our recipient's lead by example style and concern for others makes him a positive role model for other cadets. In addition, this student excels academically and ranks among the top 20 of the senior class. She has received numerous accolades for her academic accomplishments, including receiving the Military Officers Association Award for Leadership and Academic Achievement, and the Top Scholar Award for having the highest GPA of all JROTC cadets. Congratulations to Janice Vega, recipient of the JROTC's Outstanding Senior Award.
Hi, it's Ms. Bazunu again. So I will be presenting the Guidance Department Award. The student receiving this award promotes the importance of college and career readiness. Her profound insight to post-secondary preparedness is impressive. To better herself academically, personally, and professionally, she has volunteered her time and has participated in programs to gain knowledge about life, college, and career skills. This student has done well in various leadership roles, and she ranks among the top 20 of her senior class. She has consistently stayed on top of completing essential tasks as a senior and preparing for her post-secondary life. I have never seen a student so enthusiastic about applying to colleges and scholarships, registering for the ACT and SAT, and completing the FAFSA. The student even took the initiative to host college and scholarship application get-togethers to help motivate her peers to apply because she desires to bring success to others, not only to herself. I will greatly miss seeing this student in the guidance office on a regular basis. Congratulations to Cherise Villiers, recipient of the Guidance Department's Outstanding Senior Award.
Laura Telewicki, I'm going to be announcing some department awards for our seniors. This student chosen for the Physical Education Department Award is accountable and responsible, attended class every day, dressed out, and participated. They were a pleasure to have in class and excelled in class just like they did on the wrestling mat. The student has a very bright future. Congratulations to Jesse Gare, recipient of the Physical Education Department's Outstanding Senior Award. Next, we have our Journalism Award. This was a student's second year with yearbook. However, you would have thought they were doing this all 4 years. So many afternoons were spent with Ms. Muehlberger, the journalism teacher, until almost 6 p.m. in the yearbook room. The student went above and beyond, even working on the weekends to get pages completed. Mrs. Muehlberger can't begin to thank her enough for her dedication. Congratulations to Ronnie Gaskin, recipient of the Outstanding Senior Award for Journalism. Our next is a Science Department Award. The Science Department has chosen a student for the stellar work they have done in the science classes throughout their years here at Lake Gibson. They're an excellent leader and continuously seek out opportunities to not only learn, but to learn new and exciting science on the threshold of discovery. This student has proven to be an asset throughout the sciences, and we would like to proudly recognize their efforts, their drive, and their endurance, not only as an outstanding student, but also as an outstanding peer. Before the quarantine, they were even hosting AP study sessions to help their fellow classmates. Congratulations to Jerry Thompson, recipient of the Science Department's Outstanding Senior Award. And lastly, the Math Department Award. This student has been a standout in AP statistics. All year, the student has been impressive with their dedication to learning. Even in the shift to distance learning, the student has never failed to complete assignments and seek help when needed. Not only is this student a hard worker, he has deepened his understanding of statistics. On behalf of the math department, we want to wish this young man luck as he moves on to his next chapter at the University of Florida, where we have no doubt he will excel. Congratulations, Oscar Santiago Perez, the recipient of the math department's Outstanding Senior Award.
Greetings, I am Ms. Wallace. I am the Business and Finance Department Chair and a senior sponsor here at Lake Gibson High School. I am presenting the awards for the Business and Finance Department. The first award will be for the Academy of Finance. The recipient of the Academy of Finance Outstanding Award goes to a student who has been very active in the program for 3 years, participating in district events and winning first place, maintaining an A average in all financial classes, and serving as president of the Finance Club DECA. Congratulations to Tariah Demings, recipient of the Academy of Finance's Outstanding Senior Award. The next award is for the Polk Academy of Business and Technology. The recipient of the Polk Academy of Business and Technology's Outstanding Senior Award is a wonderful person who has been a part of the Academy for 4 years. This student has been a valued addition. They have gone above and beyond when asked to do anything. They always meet the deadlines given to them, and they are willing to help their peers with a smile and an air of humbleness. On behalf of the Polk Academy of Business Technology, congratulations to Shamara Smith, recipient of the Outstanding Senior Award. And the final award for the Business and Finance Department, it would be the Business Department Award. The student's knowledge of computers and willingness to share their expertise and time to the Business Department has been exceptional. Their pleasant demeanor and continued tenacity with issues that face our department with all its technology has truly kept our department running smoothly. Congratulations to Jalen Page, the Business Department's recipient of the Outstanding Senior Award. Thank you, Jalen, for all you have done. You are truly deserving of this award.
Hi, class of 2020. My name is Lori Johnson, and I am the World Language Department Chair and also a very proud senior sponsor. Today, I'm going to be awarding some department awards. I'm very honored to do so. The first one is going to be the Foreign Language Department. For French, this year's award goes to a student who has excelled in 2 years of French. This year, in French 2 honors, they earned a 100% in 3 of the 4 9 weeks, and the other 9 weeks, they earned a 98. They are a hard worker, very conscientious, helpful to others, and extremely responsible. As the French teacher, I wish them the very best of luck in the future, and I cannot wait to hear about all the great things they accomplish. Congratulations to Dustin Fandetti, recipient of the Foreign Language Outstanding French Student Award for Seniors. Great job, Dustin. We appreciate you. The Department Award for Spanish. This student has been enrolled in AP Spanish courses for 2 years. Ms. McSwain, the Spanish teacher, says it has been an honor to have them in class. They are mature, responsible, always diligent in their classwork, and they are the most positive role model for their classmates. They consistently demonstrate initiative, leadership, and dedication. Ms. McSwain has no doubt that they will achieve great things in the future as they epitomize the concept of brave. Congratulations to Ali Nunez, recipient of the Foreign Language Department's Senior Award for Spanish. Congratulations. The award now for Biotech Academy. This student headed up the Biotech Project partnership with the University of Florida. Not only did they write and receive a grant for $1,800, but their passion for the project has pushed through several barriers where the Academy has been able to accomplish at least half of what it set out to do, despite the setbacks. The student has continued to be the one to turn to when we needed help in the lab and with the program. With their assistance and dedication, Biotech has continued to be a successful program and they will be greatly missed. This award goes to Sophia Castrillon. Congratulations, she is the recipient of the Biotech Academy's Outstanding Senior Award. And now for the Culinary Academy. This Culinary Academy Student of the Year has completed culinary levels 1 through 5, starting in 8th grade with High School Culinary 1. They have been a highly motivated young sous chef in Culinary Academy from the start, and has been involved with the Career and Technical Student Organization, FCCLA, for 7 years. They have competed at nationals for 6 years. This student has displayed their skills, knowledge, leadership throughout their high school career. They have displayed multiple talents when put in charge of multiple community dinner events, directing 15 to 20 students while organizing the 50 families in attendance. This student has also passed the National Registry of Food Safety Professionals and ServSafe exams, both tested for certifications at the manager level. This student is currently a shift leader at Chick-fil-A and has been a great leader and student. Congratulations to Sean Hara Prasad, recipient of the Culinary Academy's Outstanding Senior Award. And now for the Social Studies Department Award. The Social Studies Department Award is going to a wonderful student that is passionate about social studies. This student has taken 7 of the AP Social Studies courses offered at Lake Gibson High School. Their inquisitive nature is endearing and humorous at times, and they are a pure delight to have in class due to their hardworking nature and willingness to help those around them. Congratulations goes to Dominique Neveu, the Outstanding Social Studies recipient. And now for the Garnet and Gold ESE Department Award. Every day, this student greets everyone with a smile. They are always there to help a friend when they're having a bad day. They are also the master of a calendar, and they keep us all up to date and on point. Though we only had the honor of teaching the student for 2 years, we have seen them grow into the wonderful young person he is today. This student is the kindest, sweetest, and most loving person. Just don't touch their snacks. Congratulations to Arshawn Samford, recipient of the Garnet and Gold Award for Outstanding Senior for the ESE Department. For the Department of Music Chorus Award, this student has spent their 4 years of high school excelling in both the singing and dance components of the vocal ensemble. They have participated in all county 3 out of 4 years in high school and were also selected for multiple solos each year. They have also served as both dance captain and section leader their junior and senior year, as well as being on the leadership team for their senior year. The student is extremely talented and is going to be working to earn their music performance degree in the fall. Congratulations to Christian Windisch, recipient of the Music Department's Outstanding Senior Award for Chorus. And Christian was also the award winner for the John Philip Sousa Award, highly distinguished honor for our marching band.
We'll be right back.
Thank you for celebrating our seniors with our Legacy Leader Ceremony and the Senior Award Ceremony. Again, we are so proud of you and the way you handled the end of this school year and handled the adversity that was given to you. We are so proud. And remember, Lake Gibson High School may be closed, our buildings may be closed, but our school and our spirit is always open because of the great students like you.
Congratulations class of 2020.
And remember, at Lake Gibson we say, B-O-E, Braves over everything. And now Mr. Diaz with some important information.
Information in regards to graduation and picking up your graduation tickets, regalia, senior awards, and your sashes will be sent to you through our social media platforms and your portal.
Class of 2020. I am so thankful for this moment to be able to say that I love you and that I am so proud of you. My name is Mandy Stock, and I had the privilege of teaching many of you U.S. history last year. But today, we simply celebrate all that you've achieved, not only as students and scholars, not only as athletes, but those achievements you've made as family members and friends as well. So for the next couple of minutes, as these pictures scroll by, you may be tempted to feel a little sad or to feel robbed of those moments with your friends that you so rightfully deserve, those moments as seniors where you get all dressed up and you look your best and you get rewarded for all of the hard work that you've put in throughout the years. But don't do that. Trust me when I say this. You have never looked better. There is no award ceremony. There is no sports banquet, there is no prom dress or tuxedo that can make you look better than you do right now. The world is watching you, class of 2020, myself included. And what we are seeing is you reaching out to encourage and support your classmates, even those people that you wouldn't typically talk to on a normal school day. You're finding ways to serve your community. You're writing letters of encouragement to your teachers who you know are struggling too. And you're finding ways to just love your community and your neighbors. That is a beautiful, beautiful thing. And kindness looks really, really good on you. So continue in that path. Continue to choose love, choose joy, choose kindness in a world that doesn't expect you to do that. You are awesome. And I love you with my entire heart. So without further ado, here is you.